Alright guys, I've just got my bike warming up right now. Gonna go for a little ride and I'm gonna tell you about what happened last Friday. Can you hear it purring yet? What is this? So for that thing, it's a dog igloo, right? I don't know why it's here. I don't know whose it was. Yeah. But it's here. Doesn't look like it scratched the truck on the way in. Fuck's sakes, people. You know, these people are just like, hey, this guy has a dog. Let's just take our shit that we don't want to him. Just, you know, he has a dog. And I'm just like, so what?
So this last Friday was really strange. So it's like 9 or 10 p.m., right? I'm getting ready to go to bed and all that. And my Facebook Messenger goes off. So I hear that and I'm like, yeah, that's probably one of my friends trying to get a hold of me, whatever. We'll see what they want. And it's from this chick who I've never met in my life. And all it says is, hey. So, you know, I'm not an asshole. I'll say hi. So I say hey with a question mark, because, you know, I don't know this lady. She, you know, 4 or 5 messages in, I say, is there any reason you've messaged me here? And she said, yes, there is. And I said, okay. Why? She said, because I think you're really hot. And I said, and you sound hella fake. Because nobody has that much confidence in what they say, right? So I say she sounds hella fake. You know, I'm scrolling over getting ready to block her. And I see the message pop up at the top of my screen. What? I'm not fake? So I'm like, alright, fine. We'll play this game for a whole 2 more seconds, you know? So I said, what's the color of the motorcycle in my profile picture? She says green and this and that and this and that. Talking about a picture of me standing next to my bike. And I'm like, well, shit. She's real. You know, I try to be a nice guy whenever I can be. And I go and I tell her, you know what? Fine, I'll take you to dinner. She wasn't asking me to take her to dinner, first off. I told her I would take her to dinner. If someone thinks that I'm a good-looking person, they have the balls enough to tell me that I am a good-looking person, I'll take him to dinner. You know, I'm not an asshole. So I took her to dinner. I picked her up from her house in that black truck you saw at the start of the video. She's just kind of butting heads with me. Like, I have never butt heads with someone as hard as I butt heads with this woman. She's just going and arguing about little things that you don't need to argue about. Like, she's never been off-roading a day in her life, yet she seems to believe that she knows why a 6-inch lift is too tall, which, that doesn't make much sense to me. You know? So, keep in mind, this is all in the truck before we even get to dinner. We'll jump forward of all the bullshit and arguing, and we get to the restaurant, and she just starts being a real dick. She's not very nice to the staff, from, you know, my point of view. And she's being very inconsiderate. So, you know, we go and she's not being a very nice person to the staff, like, at all. And, you know, I kind of give her this look like, what the fuck are you doing? You know, because I'm wondering, what the fuck are you doing? And she chills out a little bit. Because that was at the start. And all I was, like, literally the only reason I took this girl to a dinner was because I wanted to help boost someone else's confidence. You know? If you are brave enough to say, hey, I think you look really hot, and I want to start something between us, I don't think anyone should ever, ever be, for lack of a better word, punished for saying that. Because a lot of people nowadays, if you bring out some confidence, you're getting, not yelled at for it, but, your confidence gets brought down quite a good amount. So, I'm trying to kind of not butcher someone's confidence for saying that they like me. But we just butt heads the entire time that we were at dinner. Like, I guess there was maybe, out of this 45-minute dinner, there was maybe 15 minutes where we weren't button heads and we were talking about something that we could relate on. And the only thing that we had in common was music. I want the moral of this story to be, don't hold back, you know? If you like someone, even if it's just for their looks, tell them. Because just because her and I didn't get along doesn't mean anything, because I still said yes and offered to take her out to dinner, you know? I still gave it a shot. We need to bring some confidence back, people. If you like someone, or you like something, or you want to do something, or you want to do someone, be a lot more confident. When I said, you sound hella fake, she turned out to be real, and I felt kind of like an asshole for saying someone sounded fake whenever they were just being confident in what they were doing. I didn't say anything really mean to her after she was being, you know, a very rude, inconsiderate person. I didn't say anything mean to her. And I said, alright, let's go home. So I dropped her off, and I drove away. I was done with that. It was not a very fun time, I'll tell you that much. She would go and, you know, argue stupid stuff. Like, if I said, this secondary visor here is awesome because it helps keep sun out of my eyes, you guys, the equivalent would be you saying, no it doesn't, that's stupid. You know, okay, why is that stupid? Why is it stupid to think that the sun visor helps keep sun out of your eyes? Just arguing very dumb stuff for very dumb reasons, right? So be confident in what you do and what you say. People will believe you if you're trying to tell them something, if you have confidence in what you do and what you say. And if you think someone's hot, like that girl that I was, and you say anything, like she was wanting to have a relationship, and I didn't want that, but I, you know, I said, I'll take you to dinner. I'm not going to punish you for doing something, for having the confidence to tell someone that you think is attractive that they're attractive, you know? But after that, I might never take anyone else to dinner ever again. My God, these bikes are nimble. Anyways, thank you guys for coming along on this adventure with me. I do stupid videos like this quite often. So, be sure to subscribe to see what next weird thing happens in my life. Because Lord knows, there's plenty of weird stuff that happened to me. Yeah.
Gals, in the next video. Bye!